by first saying that as a father of three young children, I saw what happened in South Africa in 2008. When my kids grow and become of age in South Africa, in the next couple of years, I would like the lights to be on. In the debate that has been going on in South Africa, especially in the past few weeks, since our government signed an intergovernmental agreement with the Russian Federation, there's been a lot of myths and misstatements that have been going on. Therefore, I thought I must locate our discussion this afternoon in the context of what is happening around the world. Therefore, South Africa, in pursuing more nuclear power, is not out of kilter with what is happening in other countries. As we speak, there are 437 reactors that are operating in 31 countries. As of July, there were 71 reactors under construction in 16 countries. We know for a fact that a number of African countries which we interact with on a daily basis, such as Nigeria, Ghana, Kenya, and others, are also actively considering nuclear power as a source of energy going forward. So therefore, the idea that South Africa may be out of kilter because of Fukushima and others is not a reflection of the reality. In terms of the new build, we know that 45 countries around the world are considering embarking upon new nuclear power programs. This is the state of the situation in the world regarding nuclear. And this is simple to understand, because the drivers for nuclear have not changed. They are the same for all countries, including South Africa. First, we seek energy security all over the world for the economies to grow, for the world to achieve the Millennium Development Goals. We have to have energy security. Climate change is another major driver of our quest to expand nuclear power. We know the story of climate change. We know what will happen if we do not take action now to mitigate climate change and to reduce our carbon footprint. Why can't we do this with a source of energy that we know is safe to start with, but also does not emit dangerous gases that are dangerous to the environment and to the atmosphere? Health and development, ecosystems, food production, all of this will be the victims of climate change. Water systems and our ability to extract more minerals that are powering the world economy, all of these will be threatened if we do not take action now. And we believe that nuclear, therefore, is one of the many other solutions that we can bring into this. But from an energy perspective, certainly a nuclear for us becomes, therefore, very critical. This is just an illustration of what we have done with the other sources of energy, petroleum, coal, natural gas, and gas flaring. In terms of the metric tons of carbon per year, this is not sustainable. I think all of us can agree. If we continue on this path, it is certainly not sustainable for the future generations, the generations of our kids. Why, therefore, does the South African government think that nuclear is important? It's important for us to expand our generation. First, South Africa faces energy constraints. This is a fact that no one can dispute. We have seen since 2008 all the blackouts, the appeals that are made, even yesterday, there were appeals that were being made to large electricity users to reduce their consumption. For to drive the economy and make it competitive, certainly we cannot continue like this. In order for our economy to grow, to be competitive in the world, to attract investors, we need a stable and reliable sources of electricity and energy. From my previous life as an ambassador of South Africa, I have met many investors who want to come to South Africa to come and invest, create manufacturing factories, create jobs. But they keep asking about the question that they keep asking is about our energy, the reliability of our electricity. In September last year, I was in Austria, in the province of Austria, where I spoke to a company that is in a very high-tech industry, who wanted to come to South Africa to invest, bring high-skill, high-technology to South Africa, create jobs, and all of that. But they kept asking me, can we trust the electricity supply in South Africa? I saw their technology, I toured their plants, and they showed me how sensitive their production process was to any electricity blackouts, any electricity stoppages. I believe that this is a story across the world. if you were to talk to those who are trying to attract investments to our country. Therefore, we are not talking here on ideological grounds. We are talking practicalities. This is what our country needs. We are aware of the aging energy infrastructure that we face. The chairperson talked about some of the existing coal power stations. We know that in the next decade, some of these will have to be mothballed. They will have to be decommissioned. This is the reality, ladies and gentlemen. As I said, I will try to run away, as the chair suggested, I try to run away from ideology and speak reality and facts. Our development agenda, we know for a fact from the NDP, and all our development frameworks, it is energy intense. It requires more electricity production. If we are to, South Africa is to achieve the Millennium Development Goals, certainly we need to generate more energy, more electricity. The president was in New York last month at the United Nations General Assembly, giving a report of how far South Africa has gone in towards the achievement of the Millennium Development Goals. Clearly, if you look at the MDGs, the one MDG that is missing is an MDG on energy. Because none of the MDGs can ever be achieved without a reliable energy supplies. And this is the case for South Africa as well. Therefore, our development agenda, we know it ourselves. It is indeed energy intensive. Our long-term mitigation scenarios ask us to reduce carbon emissions by 34% in 2020 and 42% in 2025. We cannot do this without moving towards more cleaner energy generation. We also know how important it is for countries to diversify their other sources of energy for the resilience of our electricity system. Now, there has been a lot of talk about the new build program. The government has said very clearly that when we talk about the new build in 2014, we're not talking about buying nuclear power plants off the shelf, but we're talking about building and revitalizing a nuclear industry in South Africa. It's an industry that we have already, an industry in which we have so much expertise. And therefore, the nuclear build will help South Africa to become a supplier of nuclear products and services. This is the goal and the ambition that our government has set. It will certainly contribute to job creation. Today, we are asking our kids to study maths and science. This new build program will bring to South Africa more high-tech skills, not in the sense of the nuclear power plants themselves, but also in the sense of the other linkages that will be there in the broader economy. More knowledge will come to South Africa, as I said, and energy security. The integrated resource plan, as we all know, envisages a 23% nuclear component by 2030. This is another myth that we need to clarify today. There is only one IRP that has been adopted by government. It is the IRP 2010. There is no other IRP. A document that was circulated last year, on which there has been a lot of discussions, was a draft document. And I believe that a new document will be released, which is different from what was released last year. I want to spend time on this because there's been a lot of discussions in the media and in other areas where people seem to be saying the South African government moved away from the IRP 2010. There is nothing like that. I mean, this is a fact. This is what the Integrated Resource Plan says. As you can see, nuclear is not against renewables. Our government is pursuing an energy mix. If you look at what is being envisaged, 42% will come from renewables. That is almost double what is expected from nuclear. Therefore, it is an energy mix. Nuclear is not against any of the other energy sources. The point also which has been raised is the whole question of safety of nuclear technology. We know that the nuclear industry all over the world for the past 60 years has been improving the safety. This is the same thing that happens in all other industries, whether it is the aircraft industry, whether it is the motor industry, whether it is agriculture. No industry rests on its laurels when it comes to safety. So the nuclear industry has been making strides to improve safety. And we know this, I don't have to go into details. The current generation of nuclear reactors that are being built and constructed are far different from those that were built in the 70s and in the 80s. We are now on generation 3 plus when we started in generation 1. So there is a vast difference, there is improvements that we cannot deny. On top of that, we have learned valuable lessons, all of us, from the Fukushima accident. Immediately after the Fukushima accident, the nuclear industry all over the world, and including in South Africa, we went into stress tests to see how we can apply and improve on the lessons from Fukushima. And I'm happy to say that from what I heard, South Africa, the stress tests that were done in South Africa showed how the improvements that we already had in areas where we were already advanced than some of the improvements that will come as a result of the Fukushima accident.
2 minutes.
The chair asked the question, how will South Africa, if we cannot do other things that seem easier, how are we going to run a nuclear industry of the scale that we want? And the answer is simple. We have the expertise in South Africa. Next year in March, at NECSA, we will be celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Safari reactor. This year, Quebec is celebrating 30 years since the commissioning of the two units. South Africa has immense nuclear technology expertise. I believe and I'm confident that we will be able to run and operate the new nuclear power plants. I thank you.